So what is the most common cause of hair loss? Well, if you guessed androgenic alopecia, you are correct. Now, what is androgenic alopecia? Well, it's pattern hair loss. Now, in men, it's the receding hairline and also loss of hair on the top of your head. Now, in women, it's a little bit different. It's a kind of a diffuse thinning of the hair all over. Now, this is actually very, very common. It affects 50 to 80% of men and 25 to 50% of females at some point in their lives. Now, the way hair loss medication works, there's a couple different mechanisms. One popular drug works by increasing oxygen, nutrients, and nitric oxide to the scalp, which increases circulation. But most hair loss medications work by inhibiting a certain enzyme. And that enzyme is called 5-alpha reductase. Now, what does this enzyme do? Well, it allows testosterone to be converted to a much more powerful form of testosterone called DHT. If you have too much DHT in your body, what happens is you get a thickened dermis around the hair follicles. So it's going to suffocate the hair follicle. You get increased fibrosis. That's kind of like a scarring, which wraps around the hair. And then you also get calcification around the hair follicles. So that's what DHT does to your hair. So DHT is a type of androgen. So what's ironic about androgens in general is they normally increase body hair, but then not on the top of your scalp. You get a loss of hair on the top of your scalp, which is pretty odd. Now, let me just explain more about this enzyme, 5-alpha reductase. Now, when someone experiences castration, there's a 95% decrease in androgens. And what happens at the same time is they stop losing their hair. They stop experiencing androgenic alopecia. Another point I want to bring up is people who are balding nearly always have an increase of DHT in their scalp. And people who are deficient in this enzyme, 5-alpha reductase, do not develop hair loss. So apparently this enzyme is a key factor if you're going to develop hair loss or not. My question is, what increases this enzyme? And if you guessed insulin, you guessed correct. Because insulin resistance, hyperinsulinemia, which is too much insulin, and other conditions that have too much insulin, like PCOS, polycystic ovarian syndrome, like obesity, like metabolic syndrome, are all associated with androgenic alopecia. Also, low progesterone can increase this enzyme as well. And where do you see low progesterone? In menopausal women. So, based on that data, what do you think you should do? Get in a low-carb diet. Start doing intermittent fasting. Now, there are natural things you can take to inhibit this enzyme as well. Because the problem with taking a drug to inhibit this enzyme is there's side effects. With natural remedies, there are less side effects. The big one is saw palmetto. That is a great inhibitor of this enzyme. Zinc can inhibit this enzyme. DHA, which is an omega-3 fatty acid, can inhibit this enzyme. And GLA, which is another specific type of fat, can help you inhibit this enzyme. All right, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video. So if you're enjoying my content, which I hope you are, and you're applying this knowledge to your health, and you have a success, I would really appreciate you sharing your success story. So click the link down below to my website where you can upload your success story so you can help inspire others.